girls, and welcome to Gateway Kids. I'm so excited that you're here. It is a new month. With a new month comes a new virtue. Last month, we studied all about determination. This month, our virtue is faith. Faith is trusting in what you cannot see because of what you can see. Ah, I love to look at faith. Our bottom line this week says, you can know Jesus even though you've never seen him. And we're going to see how that plays out in our Bible story today. I'm so excited that you could join us. I want you to participate, stand up with his crew. They've got some new songs for the month. It's going to be a lot of fun because there's some fun songs. So I want to say happy birthday to my sweet birthday friends. We are to June. It's summer is here. Let me give you a big old air hug. I love you guys. Hope you have a wonderful birthday. So let's pray and we will get started. Heavenly Father, we are just so grateful to be here this morning on this beautiful morning, God, that you've given us. We thank you for all that you do in our lives, God. And God, we just look forward to what you're going to continue to do as we move through this tough time, this pandemic. We pray for those that are ill, those that are still fighting it, God. We pray for the unrest in this world, God. We pray for injustice, Father. We pray for all these things that are going on, God. We know that you see this, that none of it has escaped your sight. We also know that, God, that you have a plan. And Father, we put our trust and our faith in that plan. So I pray this morning that our hearts and our minds will be open and receptive to your word. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. And all God's children say, amen. All right, guys, it's time to call out his crew. Let's do it on the count of three. One, two.
Very good. you're the way. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the life he saved me from. Thank God. Hey church, now you see this little light of mine. Well, my question is a simple one.
Who's next?
Come get in line. I'm talking one by one. Gonna testify that it's only by God's grace we're standing here today. If you feel the one I'm feeling, let me hear you say, hey, amen. If you're a new creation, amen. If you got that feel good in your soul, that hope that won't let go. If you feel the one I'm feeling, let me hear you say, amen. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the light. I can see the light. He saved me. He saved me from. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the light. He saved me from. Every time I look. If you feel the one I'm feeling, let me hear you say, amen. If you're a new creation, amen. If you got that feel good in your soul, that hope that won't let go. If you feel the one I'm feeling, let me hear you say, amen. Amen. If you're a new creation, amen. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the life he saved me from. Every time I look back over my shoulder, I can see the life he saved me from. Thank God.
Feed me fear.
Good morning, kids. Welcome to today's lesson. And it's the start of summer, right? That's awesome. The only bad thing about this summer is you can't get away from your teachers. You're at home with your mom and dad, your new teachers. So, wait, I got an idea. Maybe this summer we can just cancel it. Since you're there with your teachers, we can just continue to have classes all summer long. You can continue learning and doing homework. I must have temporarily lost my mind to recommend that you guys go to school all summer. That is just complete craziness. So let's move on to the lesson for the month. So for June, we're going to be talking about faith. And God gives us a great, perfect example, definition of faith in the Bible. And this is in Hebrews 11:1. And this is actually our memory verse for the month. So it says, faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. See, we don't see God, right? Have you ever met God? I haven't met God. Have you ever met Jesus? No, I never saw him in person, right? But there was actually, outside of the 12 disciples and those original believers, there wasn't a whole lot of other people who saw Jesus either, or saw what he was capable of. But we can still experience God. And that's what we rely on. And so, like the Life app says this week, it says, trusting in what you see, what you can't see, because of what you can see. So God is constantly working all around us and doing great, great things. And so that is how we can have faith in God. So are we always able to be faithful? There's times when we have doubt, and that's natural. We're going to question whether something's true or if it's false. But God knew this, and he gave us one of the fruits of the Spirit as faithfulness. And that is so we can rely on the Holy Spirit to really strengthen our faith and really help us out when we get in some of those tough times. So if you remember the fruits of the Spirit, there were 9 of them, right? So it was love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, the 2 G's. There was goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control. Don't feel bad if you got to use your fingers. I even saw Pastor Randy do it one time, and that's why I always do it, because I always forget 1 or 2 of them. Anyways, so God knew that it was not going to be easy for us to be faithful, and there would always be questions, and we would always have some level of doubt. So he made that as one of the spirits, of the fruits of the Spirit, so that we could rely on the Holy Spirit to help us through those times of doubt that we have, so that we can be faithful and we can have faith in him. Let's go to the video so we can hear about a bunch of people who had faith in God. I think you're gonna recognize a few of these names.
And I'm so excited about it being summertime!
Summertime! Summertime, yeah! Ooh, 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 ooh.
One reason I'm so excited is because I have developed my very own STEAM Lab! Look it, check it out, check it out, check it out, check it out! Look it, look it! Isn't that so awesome? You're probably wondering what that stands for. Science, Technology, Engineering, Art, and Mathematics! Sure how things will go in my lab this summer, but luckily I have faith. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. You see? You see what I did there? I have faith that I'll learn a lot and probably have fun doing so. I mean, just look at this place! Check it out.
Whoa!
Oh, wait. Perfect. Check out this microscope! Microscope, 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 microscope! I've always been amazed how microscopes can let you see things that you normally can't see. Take hair, for instance. Ow. Ah, look at that one. See, it looks like a thin line. Mine's kind of curly. Ooh, you can't see it, can you? But put it under a microscope.
Wow!
Cool, right? What about the inside of a piece of grass? Put it under a microscope! Whoa! Look at that! The inside looks like a whole bunch of smiley face emojis. I mean, you never see that just by looking at grass. Today's Bible story is all about not being able to see everything, but remembering that God always does. It's like he's always looking through a microscope or something. So, let's take a look at this story and see what we can find. Unbelievable! Is that really what my hair looks like?
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Hebrews, chapters 11 and 12.
Gotta have a little faith, 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 faith. Keep the faith. Take a leap of faith. You know, a lot of people toss around the word faith lately. We say you can break the faith or just take it all on blind faith. But true faith isn't blind at all. It's much more than just an inspirational word. True faith has to do with believing in all the things you can't see because you start with what you can see. Now, we can't see God with our physical eyes, but we can see the stories of people who came before us. They lived in a broken world like we do, but they chose to follow God. They chose to trust his promise that one day he would send a rescuer that would make everything right again. The writer of Hebrews in the New Testament tells us about some of these men and women in God's story. People like Noah. People like Abraham.
Abraham.
When God called Abraham, he was already getting old. He and his wife Sarah didn't have kids.
Leave your country and your people. Leave your father's family. Go to the land I will show you. All nations on earth will be blessed because of you.
God was planning on sending his rescuer as one of Abraham's great, 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 etc. grandchildren. But still, even though Abraham had God's promise, he still couldn't see the one God was sending. Still, Abraham went on a wild adventure, following God's call. And even his descendants, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph, all chose faith in God. Moses, too, was called by God from the fiery heart of a burning bush. Even though he was raised by Pharaoh's daughter, he chose to stand with his own people and face Pharaoh's anger to win freedom. We read about it like this in the book of Hebrews.
Moses suffered shame because of Christ. He thought it of great value.
See, when you check out Hebrews, you discover this huge list of people who followed God by faith, so many that the writer just stops trying to list all of them. Oh, but we can't forget Israel's most important king, David.
Get up and anoint him. This is the one.
Even though God had promised David would be king, though, David spent years on the run from King Saul, fearing for his life. Still, he chose to trust God.
The Lord is my shepherd. He gives me everything I need.
Now, none of these people in the Old Testament could see with their eyes how God was going to save his people, but they could see how he was working in their lives, how their needs were being met. So they chose to believe in his greater plan. They chose faith.
Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. That is what the people of long ago were praised for.
Now, here's where the story turns. In Hebrews, we discover that none of those people in the Old Testament received what God had promised here on earth.
That's because God had planned something better for us, so they would only be made perfect together with us.
God's plan includes all of us from the very beginning of creation. So at just the right moment, at the perfect point in time, God sent his rescuer, the hero, his very own son, Jesus. Jesus showed us how to live. He showed us what God was like, and he told us the most important thing.
If you love one another, everyone will know you are my disciples.
Love God, love others. It's the heart of the whole story. But then, Jesus was killed,
and his friends thought the story was finished. Period. Dot. The end. Until God raised him back to life. Jesus has defeated death, and those who follow him can live with him forever. But how do you follow someone you can't see? Well, that brings us back to faith.
Let us keep looking to Jesus. He is the one who started this journey of faith, and he is the one who completes this journey of faith. He paid no attention to the shame of the cross. He suffered there because of the joy he was looking forward to. So think about him. Then you won't lose hope.
The early believers, Peter and John and other followers of Jesus, had seen him teach and heal. They saw him after God raised him to life. But after Jesus returned to heaven, the believers continued to live by faith.
We have to speak about the things we've seen and heard.
Because of what the new Christians in the early church had seen, they could believe in what they could not yet see, the end of the story, where God makes everything right. They kept the faith, and because they did, we can choose faith too.
Woo! Take a look at this one. Any guesses on what that is? It's the inside of a carnation stem. It's amazing how things look so different under a microscope than they do just with our eyes. It makes me think of Hebrews chapter 11. It's where we can look back to all these people in history who had faith in God. Even though they couldn't always see how things would turn out, they believed God and his promises. They lived by faith. And you can live by faith too. In fact, having faith in Jesus and what he did for you on the cross is what makes it possible for you to have a relationship with God.
Relationship status update.
Even though we can't see Jesus in person, we can still have faith in him because we can see how he's worked in the lives of the people who've come before us. That's the one thing to remember today. You can know Jesus even though you've never seen him. If you want to know Jesus more and you don't know where to start, try talking with someone who has put their faith in Jesus. Or you can read the stories in the Bible of the people who trusted God long ago. There are lots of things we can see that can help us have faith. So, I hope you guys have an awesome day! I'm gonna look at a few more things under my microscope. Like maybe my nail! Ah! Let's check it out! Oh, I need to wash my hands better. This microscope tells you a lot.
Did you recognize any of those names of those people? That's pretty crazy, right? And there's so many of these examples in the Bible of people who had faith in God and believed in him and trusted him, even though they couldn't see what the end of the story was. They followed God wholeheartedly. So it even covers in Hebrews, it says, how much more do I need to say? It would take too long to recount the stories of the faith of Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah, David, Samuel, and all the prophets. There's so many people who trusted in God and followed him wholeheartedly, without a doubt, right? And we even see that in the New Testament with people who followed Jesus, right? They just dropped everything and followed him. And they saw the miracles that he performed, right? And even with the disciples after him, when they were carrying on his word and sharing his word, there was people who just wanted to touch the garments on Paul because they knew that if they could just even get close enough to touch him, that they would be healed. That is some faith, right? So how do we have faith and how do we build up faith? Well, part of that is experiencing it ourselves and hearing these stories, right? And having faith that that will be part of us. And that can be part of our testimony. So I'm going to share part of my own personal testimony. And a testimony is an experience, a personal experience that has impacted your Christian beliefs and has made them stronger. So I'm going to share one that's happened in my life. So a few years ago, I got on this kick where I wanted to understand the science behind everything that God created, with the mountains and where the ice ages fit in and the glaciers and the dinosaurs and all that stuff, right? So I was talking with a friend of mine and he mentioned this book called the Answers Book. And this is written by Ken Ham. And they even have a kids version that's out there if you're interested. And it's a pretty good book. But at the end of each one of those chapters and explaining some of these things, there were still questions. There was still things that really wasn't answered. You still had to have some level of faith that what was said in the Bible was true, and that not all of science today really answers how God did it. So meanwhile, while I'm reading through this book, at one of our Bible studies, my good friend Jack is telling me about how he studied the covenants of the Bible once. And these are all the promises that God made with everybody in the Bible. And he said that it was just amazing when you really study all of these promises. So he does this for 3 weeks, and I didn't prompt him on anything, and he's not really trying to convince me to do it. He was just telling me about it and how great it was. And this was from years past. And so he got me interested. So I started to study the promises that God makes in the Bible. And it is absolutely amazing. And I start realizing just how intertwined the Bible is and how God formed the story of Jesus dying on the cross all the way back to Adam, and how it's all tied in through Noah and through Abraham and Moses and all the rest of the Old Testament to where we get to where Jesus dies on the cross for us and is raised from the dead, and how we're saved from that. And I quickly started to realize that I'm not reading about the Answers Book anymore. It's sitting on my nightstand and I'm not worried about it. And then right after that, God kind of spoke to me. And it's pretty rare that he speaks feel like he's speaking directly to me. But he was pretty clear in what he said. And he told me, you need to stop. Stop trying to find the answers of how I created everything. I want you to have faith. I want you to have faith that I did it and enjoy it. And I did this for you. I did this for everyone else. And you just need to believe it. When I'm ready to reveal different parts of creation and different things, I'll reveal it. Don't worry about it. All I want you to do is have faith in me and follow me and trust in me. And that was it. And ever since that day, I have never worried or questioned how he did it. I've just had faith and I've enjoyed it. And whenever I look at the mountains or I look at a picture with the glaciers in the mountains, I just awe at how beautiful it is and know that God did it somehow. And how amazing that is that he was able to do that, and the power and the majesty that he has. So ask around to your small group leaders when we get back to church, to your parents, to other people about their faith in God and why they have faith in God. And they'll share some of their testimony with you and how God has worked in their lives and why they believe in him and trust him. And there's actually one way that we do that, and you may not have realized it. What is this? This is the Bible, right? And what do we say about this? We say it is all true. So that was part of what I learned in part of my testimony, right? Is why it's all true and why we can trust that everything that's in here is true and came from God. So can you know Jesus even though you've never seen him? Like the bottom line says, absolutely. You can know Jesus in your life and have faith in that based on what the Bible tells us about everything that's happened in the Old Testament and the New Testament after Jesus, and everything that's happened in your parents' lives and all your friends' lives, and what happens in your life and how you can trust Him and how you build your faith in Him. So absolutely, you can know Jesus even though you have never met Him. We can have a relationship with God. We can have Jesus as our leader in our lives, and we can have the Holy Spirit with us as our best friend, working through us all the time. So I want y'all to continue to have faith and grow your faith in Jesus by reading the Bible, by praying, and by hanging out with other Christians and other people who believe in God, and so that they can strengthen your faith. So let's pray. Father God, thank you for all the great examples that we get in the Bible on people who have had faith in you, Lord, and who have followed you. And thank you for all those the great friends we have who can be examples for us, Lord. And thank you for the Holy Spirit, that even when we have doubts, we can come to you, and the Holy Spirit can be in us and around us to remove those doubts and to help us have faith in you. And Lord, just thank you so much for everything that you do. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, kids, I hope you have a good start to your summer. And I look forward to y'all coming back these remaining weeks of the month to learn more about faith and all the great stories that we have from the book of Acts on people who were walking in faith even after Jesus had left. And see you next week.
Okay, boys and girls, it's time for a brand new memory verse. We are going to take more of God's word and we're going to hide it in our heart. Our memory verse this month comes from the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verse 1. And it says this. It says, faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. So we're going to use the sign language. So I want you to take both your hands like this. Can you make like the little O's with your hands? You're going to take your right hand. You're going to put it to your forehead like this. And this one stays here. And you're just going to go, faith. You come and join the circles. Faith is being sure. And then we're going to do hope. The word hope is like this. So it's like little waves in front of your face. Like this with your hands, both hands. So let's do this. Let's go. Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. And that comes from Hebrews 11, 1. NIrV. Let's do it again. Ready? Put your hands like this. Those. Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. Hebrews 11, 1. NIrV. Good job, boys and girls. I hope you'll keep learning that. Keep practicing it. And I'll see you soon. Have a great day, guys.